Shadowman Canada.
DLCs are great. When you buy a game, as days go by, you can add new levels and mode to keep the replay value. But there is a big problem. Five big problems. They steal your money, they trick you, they overprice you, they add too many stuff, and they put incomplete games in the market. Chris Slate, the author of this article, says the same thing but in his own words. The article was made in 2006. He have no idea how right he was. I'm going to read the article. How do we know that we are really getting extra content and not just stuff that would normally come on a game disc as a part of the standard price? It will be too tempting for game developers to drop unfinished features if they know they can wait until after the game release to finish them, and then charge extra for them. We'll end up paying more in the long run. I respect Chris Slate. Problem number one. The game creator steals your money by making you pay for stuff that's already in the CD. For example, to play the two-player mode in Resident Evil 5, you pay $5. And in some game, you have to pay to unlock characters that's already in the CD, like Hyperdimension Nocturnia. Bad company. Bad. A good DLC should be like Freddy in Mortal Kombat. He is not in the CD and wasn't meant to be part of the game. It's a good addition. That's a good DLC. But it's very rare to see a good DLC. Problem number two. They trick you by removing half of the game before the game launch date, and they make you pay half of the game as a DLC. For example, Dance Dance Revolution for PlayStation 3. They remove half of the game music in the final version of the game and they'll sell the rest of the music as a DLC. There is only 40 music inside the CD. There was a Dance Dance Revolution on PlayStation 2 that had over 70 musics on a CD, but not the PlayStation 3 version. They are tricking you, I tell you. Problem number 3. Some DLCs are overpriced. For example, in the game of Street Fighter 4 and Arcana Heart 3, they charge you for extra colors and extra costumes. The costume of Tekken 6 and Virtua Fighter 5 are free, and it should be like that. When you go buy DLC, ask yourself one question. Does it really cost that much? What? $50 for this guy of 3? You must be joking. I wonder what type of drugs are they using to make that type of decisions. Let's see now. Here's a book that explains the effect of each drug ever existed in the history of planet Earth. Oh, I know which one. They are using the magic mushroom. I'm going to read it to you. Les champignons magiques est un perturbateur du système nerveux central. Les champignons magiques est un hallucinogène 10 fois plus puissant que le LSD. Les effets du champignon magique durent à peu près 3 à 6 heures et disparaissent habituellement en 12 heures. Des hallucinogènes peuvent parfois être ressentis jusqu'à 4 jours après l'indigestion. Here's an English translation. Those who use a magic mushroom will have just enough hallucination to overprice the DLC. On the PlayStation Network and the Xbox Live Arcade, and they won't remember anything. Problem number 4. They put too many stuff as DLC. Rock Band DLC are the perfect example. Just look at how many stuff they have. By the name of love. By the name of the heavens. By the name of justice, it's too much. I'm going to the PSN to show you that it's real. Rock Band have 45,364 downloadable content. What were they thinking? Dokolokolo, what's your opinion on them?
They are crazy.
Problem number 5. They put incomplete games in the market and complete the game as a DLC. Like Marvel vs. Capcom 3. They release DLC to complete the game. 3 weeks later, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 came out to... Seriously? Here's a friendly advice. Before you buy any game, make a research in the internet to see if the game is complete. Each balloon represents the 5 DLC problem, and I will show you how I feel with some action. My little brother is filming me, by the way. This is for stealing us. This is for tricking us. For the high price. For too many stuff. And for the incomplete games. Come back here. Take that. They think they are allowed to do anything. They think that customers are, sorry for my language, stupid. They think they can get away with anything. Well, Dokolokolo will give the 10 commandments of the DLC they should follow.
Number 1. You will honor your client to have a long life in the video game business. Number 2. You will not lie by removing content to put them in a DLC. Number 3. Sell only complete games. Number 4. Put only good DLC in a good price. For example, Freddy of Mortal Kombat. Number 5. You will not make us pay for content that's already on a CD. Number 6. Each Sunday, you will pray to make sure you didn't make any mistake. Number 7. You will not be jealous of intelligent client that's not afraid to expose your true nature. Number 8. You will not desire the body or the money of the client until you get married to the 10th commandment. Number 9. Your client is your only God and you should only listen to your client, not your greediness. Number 10. You will not kill the money or the bank account of your client.